the Sugar Free Podcast. Today we've got brains on the mind.
We'll also be discussing. Discussing pop culture and filmmaking. I'm Joey.
I'm Richie.
I'm Rick.
James.
And I am Kyle.
Well, we did. Look, man.
I was like, man, Richie, that was an ambitious joke. How are you going to bring it home? And my God, how does he do it? he really just hit a grand slam on that one. All right, so yeah, so this is the Sugar Free Podcast. We're going to be talking about our studio and what it's like to act, edit, direct music, and you know,
any tangents we come up on.
We all have roots in the arts, you know, some more than others, like, but we have roots everywhere, you know. So, there's, what, a cast of 12 of us, and then 13 counting, or 14 counting my brother and Dalton, right. So.
Most of the writers are also actors in
yes.
it.
Yes, and we'll be switching between people from podcast to podcast, just, you know, whoever's available, that right. kind of thing. Most of the time, Chance will be joining us, but he's swamped today. So, I do think it's a good idea if we were to go around and say what each of us are doing. I'm James, I'm doing the music, acting, for the most part, editing. I think a lot of that's going to be in Rick's palm, but we'll see. I set you up. You're up next.
I'm Rick. I'm acting, writing, doing some of the cinematography, and editing.
I'm Richie. I'm gonna be fucking this whole thing roundabout. I write a lot. I am gonna direct the thing. I'm gonna do the cinematography. I'm gonna help with that. I'm gonna try and help with
this. This is your baby.
Well, no.
This is absolutely your
adopted. I think.
Not so much Sugar Free Poison, but I guess writers.
I'm real. Anyway, Joey,
the baby
what,
was
what?
Born, he adopted it, yeah. raised it into what it is.
Well,
now.
So, two healthy, like, parents, like, birthed a child.
Oh,
and then, like, I like, snaggled.
Poetic.
And then I, like, fucking crawled and snaggled my way into the hospital. I'm like, this is my baby now. I'm taking it.
No, that's accurate.
That's accurate.
And now,
like
and,
that.
Yeah, I'm,
He's
yeah.
actually
yeah.
the reason I even care about this project again.
And,
Yeah, you're up, buddy.
Oh, I don't want to be up. Hi, I'm Joey, and I'm unemployed. I am acting. I won't say I'm a writer anymore. I'd say I pitch ideas when I can.
Well, this is Sugar Free Poison.
I mean, that's kind of a.
Oh yeah,
you're absolutely right.
I just completed my first draft for a horror comedy that we're gonna be releasing through Sugar Free Poison. I'm gonna be directing that and acting in it and doing the makeup as well.
I helped him with it.
I think
he
take credit
for
editing too.
I'm pretty sure I have the talking stick.
Oh. Alright, Kyle, I think that sets you up nicely though.
Me? Okay. For writers, I'm just an actor. I kind of pitch ideas when I want to.
He's kind of a bad boy.
He's kind of a bad boy. I show up late sometimes.
My own rules.
And I'm also the lead in Joey's production that he's directing and acting in.
Absolutely.
Oh, shit. Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
Like that prefix makes you sound the lead. Ooh.
Ooh, yeah.
I'm the comic relief. Does that credit me?
We're all the comic relief. Scooby and Shaggy type.
Yeah.
Nowadays, the leads of movies are also the comic relief.
Absolutely.
You know?
Yeah.
Okay, Star-Lord is... something that comes to mind.
Every other Marvel
movie.
Oh,
but have you guys seen Deadpool? God. I think that movie was... I think the thing that makes me slightly not like the movie is just the 10-year-old fans who act like it's the perfect superhero movie. It's like, oh, this guy doesn't play by the rules.
Deadpool.
Oh, yeah.
That's how I feel about this new, weird, gross, internet, cringy fandom with It.
Is there really?
Oh, it's, yeah.
Is there a fan base?
Wait, what's happened to it?
And there's like fanfic between like the actors. Like
that's already a thing,
dude. It's
they
so
in the
cringy,
book.
Dude.
They
like
in
nobody.
The book.
I'm not saying nobody gave a shit. It's like one of the best. It's my favorite book, and it's very
yeah.
popular story.
So did you think?
But that, like people in this age demographic from this to that, they
yeah.
never gave a shit.
Yeah.
Then the movie comes out, and like, oh, dude, man, like. Fucking like Richie and
yeah.
the fucking Eddie should kiss.
Well, it's not like it. I feel like it actually.
It just
cringy.
Like
no,
I.
You're right. You're right.
I will never be that guy with anything else. But with this fucking book,
yeah.
I was fucking into it before anybody
you
else.
You say you read it in like middle school.
This
then.
Is my fucking thing.
It's a hard
okay.
read for middle school.
Yeah, it's a hard
dude,
read.
Dude, you gotta understand.
Yeah, everybody's
like,
dude, I'm reading Catching Fire. What are you reading? Catching Fire. And I'm like, and I just looked at him. Stephen King's it.
They're like, oh, what happens to that? Ton of kids are fucking
teenage jerk offs. Care to read?
Nah,
man.
Nah, I'm
I'll
good.
Just read about the games.
I'll just read about like kids like
hunger.
Killing each other.
Okay, so when you say it out loud, yeah, but no, I think there's just like this parasitic group of the internet. You know, we'll call them Tumblr. This is parasitic group of the internet, and it doesn't matter what the new thing is. They're going to go to that and
well,
make
now,
musicalies. What
well,
are they called? Musicalies of whatever it is. Being at Rick and Morty.
Yes.
Like if Futurama
that's
came out today,
oh my
there
God,
would absolutely
dude. That's
be.
That's what I'm saying.
Futurama
like there's so
fans,
much shit
like.
That would be so much bigger today if
yeah.
social media was around. Like. Smallville, when that show came
holy
out,
shit.
Dude,
that would be
deal.
Fucking
it was
crazy.
The biggest thing
yeah.
at the time.
Right.
Imagine
I
if it
say,
was now.
Holy
like
shit.
Fucking Archie is taking over social media. Can you imagine if it was Superman now?
Oh my God, yeah.
Like,
are you
I mean,
kidding
I
me?
Like
I think about
like,
that all the time.
Absolutely.
I think about, like, if... Like, because the Flash show
yeah.
is, like... It's shitty. It's kind of shitty.
It's gone downhill.
Yeah, I don't like it.
It literally did what Arrow did.
I've heard
the first two seasons were really good.
I've not seen
it. And then just shit.
And then it kind of just fell into shit.
Yeah.
But, like... It like I think Smallville is way better of a
oh,
show
I love Smallville.
Than
Smallville was dope.
Any
Mike,
of the CW shows
it.
Now. You
Mike
know what
Rosenbaum,
I mean?
Rosenbaum, who played Lex Luthor, has a podcast, and he had Tom Welling who played Clark on there.
Yeah.
Oh,
they're
shit,
talking
really?
About all this. And they're like, dude, we're on the cover of like Rolling Stone and Entertainment Weekly. Can you imagine what would have happened
oh,
if you were
God.
Around now?
Yeah, they would be like Comic-Con would be a fucking
and
crazy.
And I can't help think their careers would probably benefit from it too.
Oh hell yeah.
Oh,
are you kidding
far,
me?
Yeah.
Oh my God. It
oh,
would
yeah.
be it would be crazy. It kind of sucks that, like...
And all these shows, like, Arrow and Small, like, and Flash, they wouldn't be around if it weren't for Smallville.
That's true.
Hell
Arrow
no.
literally
Hell no.
came out with, like, a teaser photo and announced it was coming out, like, right after Smallville ended.
Yeah, I remember that.
A lot of people were pissed because they wanted Justin Hartley to come back. As
mm-hmm.
Oliver
well,
Hardy,
I think that
which,
it goes to say, like,
which he's
I, this is,
really
this is like, such a
yeah,
such
yeah.
A drab statement, but, you know, anything, like the shit that we're doing, we wouldn't be able to do this if it weren't for social media.
No,
I think
no.
I don't think
hell
we'd be able
no.
to.
Not
absolutely
even
no.
not even just social media, just technological advances, dude.
Yeah, mm-hmm. but it's such a like on paper like this is, it's just funny that we can, you know, we have great cameras, we have mics, we
right.
have
like,
yeah, we've got the whole shebang,
yeah.
and we're just I mean
we're teenagers.
We're pursuing. Professionalism with this, of course, we
right?
Are, but
exactly, but we're like kids.
Yeah, we don't really have experience.
Yeah, what the
fuck?
Yeah,
making content.
Exactly.
Not
like,
at all. But it's
like
so...
this is my thing. Like, it's inspiring to hear the success mm-hmm. stories of people from like a long time ago. But my thing is, at that time, of course they were, because
yeah.
they were the only ones doing it. Now everybody's doing
so
it.
So it's hard to
so
like,
it's kind of harder to get
I
out.
See,
right
I see.
Now.
Well, okay. Here. So help me out here. You guys love him. He's the. I don't want to say lead, but I guess the front man for Comic Book Men, amazing director,
Kevin Smith.
Yeah.
I was reading an AMA from him, and he was someone's like, I have this screenplay, what should I do? He's like, I filmed Clerks with a camera at night in a,
yeah.
He's like, just go out there and make it,
mm-hmm.
I promise you will find
he
a
said,
way.
He said he quit film school after, like, it was like an 8-month program.
Really?
He said he quit film school after, like, 4 months or
he
whatever.
He sold his comic book collection.
He sold his comic, well... I heard a different... I'm not sure what's true, but he said he asked to borrow $3,000 from his parents
that
to rent a camera for, like, however long, and that's how he shot Clerks.
Oh, sure, that's cool.
And,
I mean, and
like,
he
got
it black and white because it was at night, correct?
Well, no, because black and white will look... If you don't have... Well, yeah. If you don't have the lighting for
yeah.
it, black and white's going to look...
better.
Good, it's gonna look
honestly,
better.
Honestly, that's one success story that still inspires me, because even though technology, that technology is, I mean,
when did
obsolete,
come out?
That was like, and 80s, that was right? A very long time ago. It was just the utter motivation.
He
did to just get there, and that he did it. That's what.
That's cool.
I like.
That's cool. Well, I think I hope that story doesn't go underrated. You know, like I hope that really does. Because people, I mean, okay, I guess there are people doing the equivalent like us, but still.
Like, right. And I'm hearing like people on the internet like saying like these fucking hipster like youngsters like saying like. Clerks isn't that good. It's
Clerks
just
is hilarious.
It's just like whatever.
Oh, yeah? Oh, who told you that? Fucking
like,
Jake Paul.
Yeah, fuck off, whoever you are. If you don't think Clerks is good, you don't like movies.
You don't like good things.
You don't like good things.
Here's the thing. I'm a big movie snub, and not because I watch a lot of movies, because I don't watch a lot of movies. So like, I'm gonna spend my time watching fantastic movies, and I can honestly say that.
I thought you were gonna say I spent my time watching Fantastic Four.
That's the opposite of what he was saying.
Oh god, they cannot seem to get that right. But I'm gonna go on a slightly more sugar-free poison style tangent here.
Yeah, sure, go for it.
Are you guys familiar with the I guess as they want to be identified as the boy band Brockhampton? Yes.
Yeah.
Can I say one thing?
Yeah, go for it. Go for it.
What I was saying earlier, hey kids on Instagram and shit. Pennywise isn't sexy, okay?
When he grabs Beverly,
you don't meme it and say, choke me, daddy. It's fucking scary. It's not sexy. Go on.
I'm going to plus one that, though.
That is part of the culture that the internet has made, that nothing is serious, nothing is like...
Yeah.
Everything is ironic, everything has to be funny,
everything's sexual.
Everything has to be sexual.
I think that's a big one.
Because people are scared to take things seriously
everything
and actually look at themselves.
Cringy and shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Everything has to be... Just
everything has to be cool. Like...
I must say, one thing that did make Pennywise sexy to me... Was the SNL parody? God, who's the actress who
dude,
played
I was
Kelly
like, I
Conway?
Fucking
oh, yeah.
Kate McKinnon.
I
was watching it, and
attractive.
I'm like, dude, she
she's
can
very
get it.
Pretty. She's very
she
pretty.
Can get it,
she
bro,
dude,
you know?
I would sign, I'm
too
for
bad.
That.
She's alive,
I'm very for that. Anyways, okay, Brockhampton tangent. So, Brockhampton, as they want to be identified, is as a boy band, but at the same time, it goes deeper than that. They see themselves, they all met over at Kanye West Forum, and they see themselves as, like, a factory. And obviously they're frontman by the famous Kevin Abstract, but you know they have Kevin, they have producers, they have filmmakers, they have photographers, all part of what they consider a boy band. And I was like, that's very interesting because that's kind of what we have going on too. You know, we have numbers guys, we have social media people. They're a little slacking right now, but that's okay. We have Rick, who's kind of jack of all trades. He's just Rick. He holds the shit for us. We have Joey, for example.
Just handful of shit.
I don't know a better person with makeup than you, and also you know acting and comedy, whatever you fucking your trade is. I'm just like, that's how I see us. Is such a, like, we're pretty self-sufficient. We're
I love telling people about my, I'm sorry.
No, go for it.
I love telling people about my movie because it's like, I don't want to sound all like, oh my god. It's like it was meant to happen because it's so convenient.
It's very convenient.
I have these friends that are interested in the same shit as me. I guess that's why we're friends.
Also,
do you like movies? Nope. Let's be besties.
Also, the sex is great.
No,
yeah. Obviously.
But like, I just think it's good. Hilarious. Like, you are this, like, I was gonna call you musical savant. That's not nice.
Ah!
That means you can't do anything else.
You're
so musically
incapable.
Inclined, and you're like, scoring the movie.
That's true. Yeah.
That's such a convenient thing that just happened to me.
That's
and
true.
Then I have all
yeah.
these friends that are like good actors
yeah.
and shit conveniently.
Yeah.
And it's all like a perfect storm.
It's fantastic.
It's so cool.
Because, well, I mean, the only struggle that we've had so far is that, like, we've. Ooh, excuse me.
Sorry.
No, you're good. The only struggle that we've had is The Office. What are we going to do for The Office?
Absolutely.
But other than that, like, Who's going to edit this? Who's come here? Are we going to edit this on?
Yeah, everyone's always volunteering, but I'm sure we'll end up finding like an office later. You know what I mean? Like,
I'm not worried about it. I just don't want to forget about it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, when the time comes, like I said,
there's going to be so many people jumping on that to help out. You know what I mean?
We can still hit up that art space. That's true.
So that's what I'm saying. Just the whole Brockhampton thing, and I think we'll be seeing a lot more of that. I don't think we're super independent or unique. I think we're going to be seeing a lot more of those social circles. I guess of the arts. I mean, I think the cool thing about all this too is like you see so many people getting into it. Kyle, you weren't really into the arts until your senior year. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah. So like we're seeing a ton more people get into the arts, which I think is very important.
And it's also the time. Like, people are more comfortable with doing this.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, certain friend groups are, but...
Yeah. I was talking... I'm not going to say their name. If you guys want to ask me afterwards, then I'll tell you. It was a friend's parent. And they're like, oh, so what are you doing? I'm like, well, you know, I'm trying to be a musician and an actor. And they were just like, they looked at me like I had stabbed a child in front of them. And it was just like, Jesus. Oh, I'm...
Well, you did, but that was...
I was
telling them a story.
That was
and
earlier.
They were,
he was in the trash.
I said, please pay attention. All I could pay attention to was this kid's dying body in my
And I think, you know what the coolest thing, though, is like, you know, when you're in, like, middle school and high school and you have these ideas, you want to flesh them out, but you know... You know it's not going to happen.
That's the most frustrating thing.
Oh, yeah,
when I was like 14, I'm like, dude, I want to do this, but like,
I'm still little.
I can't. I have nothing to. I don't know. I have a webcam.
But we have so many examples. Brendan Rogers show, Magic Funhouse, Gus Johnson, Par 9's fantastic.
Fantastic shit.
Oh, yeah. It's all good stuff.
Sugar Pine 7.
What is that?
You guys have never... I say this every single time we, like,
see each other.
Sugar Pine 7.
I would remember that name.
Sugar Pine 7 is, like... They do, like, vlogs, but they're scripted and they're all characters.
Oh, that's cool.
It's really funny and it's so fucking funny, dude.
Even then, like, that's just a group of friends doing...
They were part of SourceFed.
So they came off of
SourceFed and kind of used their connections to kind of, like, you know, send their way, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fucking hilarious. Look it up. Steven Sucked
Check
Dick.
Out my videos on E-Bombs World and MySpace.
You'll find my stuff in the deep, like, 2003 section of Newgrounds. No, you don't know.
No, you don't.
No, I used to play games on Newgrounds.
Everyone did. Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. Anyone with a computer at that age.
Oh, yeah. Newgrounds
I still
shit.
Do.
No, you want to avoid Newgrounds. And YouTube, I'm going to be honest with you guys. This might be a controversial statement.
Uh-oh.
At the rate things are going... I don't know how much longer YouTube really has.
Really?
Why?
Let me explain my... First off, with net neutrality, if that passes, then... I don't consider this a controversial opinion. If net neutrality passes, then YouTube, you would essentially have to be paying your service provider for sites like YouTube, Facebook, Twitter.
Oh.
Yeah, that's stupid. It's disgusting.
Yeah.
So...
That's gonna fuck us.
But that's what I'm saying. Let's say that passes. I don't think it ever will, but I at least hope not. YouTube, like, people will stop paying for it. There's gonna be different sites that open up, and it's the same thing, like, with the whole adpocalypse thing. They are just it's not hurting the big people. It's really, even though
never does.
They're speaking about it, but the smaller people, they're the ones, the people with 30k subs who have sponsors, and that's how they pay their checks. Fortunately, they have sponsors to pay their checks, but they're, as far as ad revenue, they're not getting anything.
Have you ever heard of Vero?
I have not.
I recently heard of it. I don't know much about it. I know it's like an app. It's like a website that you can just share short films on.
Oh, cool.
And say what you may about them.
No, it's fine.
But Zack Snyder has one, and he literally made a short film on his phone, and it's fucking beautiful.
That's cool. I saw that,
and like I see a bunch of people going on it. I don't know, but yeah. I don't know. I don't think it'll pass.
No, I hope not. I'm not so much worried about net neutrality. Because the people will fuck.
I don't think YouTube will ever become obsolete.
No, well, I don't know. I mean, really, 2 years ago, I never would have thought that. But looking at it now...
I think now more than ever it won't.
Really? I don't know. Richie,
I think the way I see it is like...
Unless fucking Instagram was like, you can release full videos now.
Right. The way I'm seeing it is like, everybody... Like, the big companies, like the news people, the, like, fucking, the networks on like, you know, ABC and like shit like that,
yes,
are like looking at the internet like it's a trend. They are getting like
YouTube, like YouTube is a trend.
Yeah, they're looking at YouTube like it's a trend because it's acting like a trend. Because right now in this time, we're seeing lots of the same content being very popular.
It's for mass appeal. Like if you for massive SNL, appeal, their writing has to be cultivated around the world we live in now, and you can see that kind of cater to the younger demographic.
Yeah, here's the thing with YouTube. I think I see where you're coming from. It being a trend.
Well, no, I'm not. It's not a trend. Everyone's looking at it as if it's a trend
because of the content that they're creating.
Exactly.
Yes. No. That's what I mean. I see that, but like, YouTube is enforcing that. Like, we had brilliant animators. Pendleton Ward, creator of Adventure Time, had his show on YouTube until they changed their formula that fucks these people. But instead of creating it, like, for instance, would you watch an 8-minute short film? What was that one short film? I think it was called, like, Blink or something, and it was like every time they like turn off the lights, this spooky thing happened.
The person that made that actually went on to make Lights Out, which
featured
film. So do you guys remember the name of the video?
Lights Out.
Okay, brilliant movie. We saw that one. Yeah.
I would watch an eight minute short film. This is my thing. If I either was familiar with the channel or the thumbnail enticed me, or it was over a topic or a character or something that I was familiar with, or was a certain genre I liked, or all of the above.
Yeah. So for instance, you have these 10-minute vlogs. On average, these 10-minute vlogs takes 10 minutes to make. And then lots of times I've got to even render and edit it for them. It takes 10 minutes to make. They'll upload it. They'll have a 30-second ad before. Now, then there's these 8-minute things that take people months to make.
That's
months.
My thing. Vlogs I don't like because I hate this. I just hate...
Yeah, it's awful.
I hate this.
It's
unless
awful.
It's... Even with people I really, really, really like, it's just hard for me to keep attention. It's just annoying, and it's just like, this is about nothing.
Yeah. Right, nobody... Sorry.
Well, people...
If I wanted to do... I'll just hang out with you.
But, like, what I'm saying...
go with you to the grocery store.
It doesn't matter, and technically it does. You have that 10-minute threshold, but it doesn't matter what this content is. I would always rather watch the 8-minute one. Doesn't matter how many ads you put in front of it.
Absolutely.
So would you watch extra ads to support some content that you like? Yeah.
Absolutely.
I absolutely would. So why is that not happening?
Well then that's because not everybody not everybody thinks like that. Everyone thinks that those ads are just pissing them off, so they're like, I'm not going to watch that
almost
now.
Exactly.
Like, it's almost like, would you, I don't know how should I put this? It's almost like, would you rather watch fucking Dark Knight with commercials or Fantastic Four with no commercials?
Exactly, right.
Yeah.
For me, that's not hard at all.
Yeah,
like,
no.
That's Dark Knight. Like, I don't know.
Well, exactly, because we would do that for the one we liked.
But, like, the overall, like, population doesn't think that way because they don't understand or the effort that it takes to put into that stuff.
Well,
so they're just like, oh, this ad's just
going
to be awesome on that video.
You know what? That's what people, we should have a disclaimer before every video. Hey, we put a lot of work into this asshole. And then that's it.
Don't skip it.
Some people have viewer discretion advised. We just have a big middle finger that says, don't fuck us.
Don't fuck us.
So I think one of the things YouTube could do better is they used to have tags and stuff that people would use, right? They don't even have that anymore. So I think there's really
Like click this to go here?
No.
Like tags. It's pretty much like hashtags.
Yes. Okay.
So,
exactly. So if you search it.
How it's
like spooky
like
house, you would tag it as
lifestyle, leisure.
They don't have that anymore.
No. They got rid of it. So now people pollute their description with stuff, so that way it gets picked up. But my point is they need a better organization system, because if it was put into like vlogs over here, like if there's like a, these are the vlog channels you're subscribed to, they've uploaded vlogs, or like, you know, Phil DeFranco, he's huge, so those are over there, and then you go to the middle, and my favorite animator, Chris O'Neill, he doesn't even animate for YouTube anymore. Fortunately, he's working on a Adult Swim show, but like, I would always gravitate to see if these creators, or any creators, have uploaded something to the likes of that, rather than these 10-minute ads.
See, that's why I'm worried about what I'm making.
Why? You don't think it'll...
It's risky, because I know it's going to be... The parts are still going to be pretty lengthy as far as YouTube videos go. So, I mean, it's... gonna have to draw people.
We can always put it on that app that you were talking about. We can always put it on other stuff.
Fuck.
I mean, that is the biggest one we could put it on, but I think there are other options that we could use.
I want to, like, something, like, all this is, like, great and all this is, like, fine. Yeah. But, like, I don't know about you guys, but, like, I want to make movies.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, favorite fucking thing that Quentin Tarantino has ever said, somebody asked, like, I think this was, like, 2015 Comic-Con or some shit. Yeah. Somebody asked him, hey, this is the internet age. Thousands of people making content and making movies and making shit and putting it on the internet, and most of them don't get noticed at all. If you don't know, Quentin Tarantino's first film, Reservoir Dogs, was made independently.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
At the time, it wasn't as big as it was now.
But it got noticed.
Exactly.
And he got another job.
Exactly.
Yeah. He said, the guy asked, with this internet age and so much stuff getting made, how do you expect a new generation of filmmakers to get noticed? And Quentin Tarantino said, just make a kick-ass movie.
Yeah.
And
that's a badass thing to say.
Yeah, it really is. What else did he say? He said, the ocean is like, there's a bunch of waves going on the ocean.
Exactly.
But make a fucking tidal wave and let people know about
that's
it.
That's all
you
can say. You can't.
That's a good analogy, right?
Yeah, as far as getting noticed.
Is that yours?
In,
no, that was.
Oh, he saw one.
As far as like filmmaking, you can't break it up into like. Sometimes it is luck. A lot of it is luck.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
But you can't. Break it up into a formula. At the end of the day, you just gotta fucking do your best work.
Yeah. And here, let me.
Simple as that, really.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let me wait here. So, in your worry of people not having the patience for it, I can tell you. So right off the bat, we have these ideas to abuse and exploit YouTube's referral system. For instance, by uploading daily, or at least on a schedule. So for instance, we'd be uploading things like these, like podcasts, and we'd be uploading sketches, we'd be uploading, I know we've talked about just doing like just behind the scenes B-roll, all of that stuff, just having people come on and talk about something, that kind of thing. So that way, when your thing does come out, first off, it's gotten plenty of advertising on top of promoting itself. So I wouldn't be worried about it, especially since that's probably, well, definitely going to come out before writers. I really wouldn't be worried about it if I were you. Especially since, I mean, I know as soon as it's out of your hands and it's being edited and rendered, like, you'll probably start working on something else anyways while that happens, so... I wouldn't worry about it. It's the same thing with writers, of course, too. And except for writers with 14 people, we'll have plenty of content creators.
I've already developed. I'm already like writing down like ideas for like a mini series.
For a mini series based on Spooky House?
No. It's kind of catered towards more of the. It is something that I think could be cool, but it's more. Catered towards like the millions of people that like Riverdale.
Oh, Riverdale's fantastic.
Is that the one you were telling me about?
Yeah, with Cole Sprouse.
That would be really
I haven't watched it yet.
Dude, it's fucking
I know,
amazing.
It's great. I haven't watched it yet either.
That's what I'm saying. If fucking now with social media, Archie is the biggest fucking thing.
Yeah, like what the
imagine
fuck?
Smallville was right now.
No, dude. I was like reading, Archie back in like when I was a kid back in 2005. And now, like, it's a thing? What the fuck? That's crazy.
It's very weird.
It's so weird.
It's fucking
amazing. Okay,
is it, like, a teen drama?
No.
Like,
no.
It's,
no.
But it's, like, fucking Archie and, like, a little bit of, like, Twin Peaks, like...
Because it looks like it, like, a, it looks like a, like, what is
well,
that
honestly,
fucking
like, that
ABC
is the...
Family show?
No, I...
Like,
Pretty Little Liars?
Yes, it looks
yeah,
like
it's
that.
Not.
It
I
looks like Pretty
you,
Little
not.
Liars.
The characters are so good.
Yeah.
You
okay.
love the ones you they write to love and you hate the
yeah.
ones
okay,
they
so,
write
Richie,
to
Richie, this
okay.
is how it was explained cool. to me. Zach Davis pretty much gave it almost like a Scooby-Doo-esque vibe to it. Like a really mature Scooby-Doo vibe to it. Because, I mean what else has that vibe right now?
Cole Sprouse is fucking fantastic.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, he's their poster boy right now.
Yeah, and so. you got Luke Perry.
who my middle name, Dylan, is based off of his fictional character from Beverly Hills.
Really? Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. You got fucking Skeet Ulrich, who played Billy in Scream, as fucking Jughead's dad.
That's really cool.
Really? Yeah, he's dope.
That's really awesome.
Fucking Molly Ringwald plays fucking Archie's mom.
What? That's crazy! Holy shit! Oh my god! Wait, I'm gonna watch that like after we're done with this. That got me hyped. Oh my god.
And it's really good. And one thing I've noticed is this is nothing to do with what we're saying.
Yeah.
I've noticed that recently, like, girls and like just fan base cater towards the odd character now. Like, you know,
sure.
Like Jughead as opposed to Archie.
Yeah.
And right. Like, I don't watch it, but like in Teen Wolf, oppose more Tumblr. To Styles than
Tumblr, yeah.
That's true, I
They're
guess.
Doing that to try and be different, but they're actually all trying to be different. No, but so I all get being it, the same thing. You know what I mean?
Right, no, but like Jughead, I get it.
Stupid,
like,
but yeah, weird.
I know. That's how I always felt about the Hufflepuff house. Like,
yeah.
No, not you. You actually took the test and got in to Hufflepuff. But for me, it was like,
Hufflepuff.
I knew so
I'm
many people who...
Fuck Hufflepuff.
Just was like,
you.
I just want to be quirky.
To be fair, I did that until I got sorted into
Did you really?
And then I was like, oh, guess I was right this whole time.
But I don't know, you know, that's just me throwing out there. I do
Ravenclaw
think,
for life!
Yeah, okay, yeah. Okay.
Ravenclaw over everything!
Most of us in writers
Yeah,
are.
Boy, Queefle D.
Queefle D.
Yeah, okay,
I'm
so...
I'm
Ah, jeez. You guys are so quirky.
Well, that's not even an actual
Suck
thing.
I know. But, okay, so, back to Sugar-Free Poison. Real quick, how long do we want to go? For this podcast, how long?
Let's keep going.
Let's just keep going until we're out of juice.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure, I'm having a good time.
Yeah.
I'm having a good time. I can put this. Yeah, we're good. So, back to Sugar-Free Poison. And talking about the show. I thought it'd be cool if we actually said who our actor... Who is everyone on it.
You want to talk about a little bit about the show?
Yeah, I want to talk about the show.
Okay. The show, it's called Writers.
Okay.
I'm very familiar. it's focused on, it's a sitcom.
If anybody out there listening is listening, have ever seen Pulp Fiction, it's nothing like
that. It's nothing like that at all. It's, the best way I've heard it described is, I don't want to compare it to these things because we sound pretentious.
It's The Office.
Plus,
Sunny.
Always Sunny. Pretty much.
I must say,
and that's like kind of a that's kind of a niche that we kind of found that like nothing has been kind of like made to be like that. It maybe Workaholics a little
workaholics.
Bit.
It's got
a little.
But I think Workaholics
that's still,
is a little more out.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
a little
yeah.
more
yeah.
towards.
I feel
like
it's gonna be shot like Workaholics though. That's how I see it up here.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, I see
like
it like that.
So I was gonna say like I used to. Beatbox for an acapella group, and everyone was like, "Oh, like Pentatonix," and I was like, "Oh my god!" So I know we're gonna end up like that with
right.
the show too. So, oh, like The Office.
Yeah.
No.
Right.
We're already there.
Yes,
I know.
Anytime
we're already there.
We explain the show
Look,
to anyone.
It's so
like,
easy.
Oh,
look at workplace sitcom when the poster boy of workplace sitcom is literally called The Office.
Right.
Like. What? Yeah. So, anyways, to talk about our cast, I think this started with the lot of us. Richie was going to shoot a music video for my band at the time. And then we started kicking around the idea of doing sketch comedy, which then evolved. So we started off with our original 9 people.
Well, let me tell my version of the story because my version of the story is very different.
Clean it up for me.
So like a month. Like, before that, mm-hmm. you were talking about the music video and how you wanted me mm-hmm. to shoot it. And then, like, I came over to your house and, like, I knew all these people, but I didn't, like, know them.
Yeah.
And I, like, kind of met all these people, like, Logan and I think Chance wasn't there. And, like, Zach and stuff. Yeah. I knew all these people, but I didn't, like, know them. Yeah. And I shot, like, a little, like, promo thing for you guys. And, I shot like a little promo
oh, yeah,
for you guys for the
right,
kicks
yeah.
for your Kickstarter,
yeah.
And then like a little while after that, you texted me and was like, "Hey, I've got this like thing. I don't know if you want to do it
yeah.
or not."
It's like a concept for like an internet show or something, like a sketch show, and it's called Writers.
Or no, that, I'm going to wait here, I'm sorry to cut you off. It was originally called Forecast, because we were like, Cloud's like me, and we're like, hey, that's a cute name. So we're going
to... See, I think you contacted me after that, because...
Really?
Yeah, well, because I never heard...
Writers wasn't my idea.
Whose was it?
I think my brother said it was... Were you in on this?
I remember you and Joey approached me about it at an improv show, and I was just like, no.
Well, I didn't know, no, because it could not, Writers was never my idea.
Also, the name wasn't Writers in the beginning, because for the longest time, we didn't have a name.
Yeah.
Because we're just...
Well, like I said, we're going to go as Forecasts for a while. Like, we didn't even settle on the Sugar-Free Poison until we moved down here.
Well, but we'd given up on Forecast when a bunch more people came in. Like,
oh, yeah, because it wasn't like a Clouds thing anymore.
Yeah, by the time I joined, right. Forecast was gone.
Oh, shit, that was really early on.
We just didn't have a name for it yet.
Yeah.
And we're just doing sketches.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we started adding in, like, a little bit of overworld in between sketches.
Right. That's right, yeah.
And then it slowly progressed into...
Everybody was like, we like this more than this.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah. Like...
Also, if anybody ever wants to start an improv group called, like, the Schizophrenics...
Oh,
I think it's good. I think it's better on text than it is set
the
out.
Sketch, no. The Schizophrenics.
Okay,
the
yeah.
The Schizophrenics. Oh, my God. So, like, okay... So, like, it started out... Somebody said the word Writers to me.
I think you and my brother...
No,
God,
I don't know.
I know I was there when we came up with the name.
You know who it was, mate.
Me and Joey.
It was that buddy down at the Roxbury.
I hope I don't sound like I'm trying to take credit for this, because the absolute opposite.
Will
I just want to give
Will
a friend...
Ferrell. Chris Kattan.
Whoever's due.
So, like, somebody approached me with the idea,
yeah,
and...
sorry, continue.
And, like, the first thing, like, you said something real fucking sketch off the top. You were like, I have this idea for a thing, but I want it to be your thing completely, and you're going to take charge of it, and you're going to do everything about it.
I was like,
what?
I had this idea, but dude, take all reins, please. I don't want it.
No, okay. Let me...
The hands, like, too. He does the hands.
I get stressed out when I have power. Not that... Is power the right word here?
No, it is. I know you're sexy.
But yeah, I get stressed out.
You're getting...
I like to start things and then just fade into the background.
That's how I am whenever I impregnate somebody.
Just kind of...
You could have said it better, Muscle.
Hey, all right. I'll see you when you're like 16 years old.
Probably not.
But so for example, yeah. So, and then from there, you know, we...
And then I was like, kind of like, no, I'm good. And then...
Wait,
hold on.
Let me interrupt you here. So at this point, it was us. And, let's see here.
Oh gosh, there was like...
Was Brian?
I remember specific.
He wanted to be real bad, but we...
And everybody was
logical. We pushed back on that.
I remember you and Joey was really wanting me to get a part of it. And I think you probably had known at this point. And we all went to an improv show. And they were sitting by us.
Yes.
So please? And I'm like, no, dude.
I remember
I just
that.
Showed up.
What improv was I?
And me and you were both like, I don't know. And I was like, but I was like, kind of like, okay, fine, I'll go.
And I was still like, fuck no, dude.
And then I went to, I think there was like a meeting.
At,
I don't, at Joey's
house. It started
house.
At Joey's house.
It started at
Wait,
Joey's
were you
house.
You not in on it then?
Yeah. I wasn't in on it until I went to the first meeting.
Oh.
And then like, you guys had some stuff written up and then... that's when I think the Kill Me Mommy shit started, where
that's
I started
right.
saying that.
Yeah.
And, like, you guys had, like, a script written.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
like,
that's what it was, because I showed up late, because I had found out that you and Joey wrote stuff for me, because you figured I would come anyway.
Yes!
No.
Because you know how I am.
Well,
like,
no, that's...
And you know I'll be like, I don't want any part of that.
We
like,
did.
All right, what's going on?
We did kind of precast, well, actually, exactly what we did. Because originally we were just doing caricatured versions of everyone. I think at this point, like, Cam was in the show for like 2 months before we actually officially asked him. So, but that's okay.
You see, I actually didn't know we were pre-casting people. I assumed Joey was just in it when I started writing.
Really?
And yeah, it's
pretty easy to honestly,
I think we should all give ourselves a pat on the back, because just thinking about where we were.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
guys, let me fucking tell you, holy shit, we didn't know how to write a script at all.
That first I think I think James didn't know how to write a script.
Well, no, because
it fucking ruined the first few drafts. Wow,
Joey and I like, were doing it too. It was
That's true. Okay,
because this is my thing. I'm even thinking about that when meetings were still at Joey's, which is nuts to think where we were at that time.
Oh my god!
And I'm not gonna say who, but you guys know what my future plans are for the most part, and I'm not gonna say who, but they were like essentially. So yeah, if we get like picked up, because that was an appropriate time to talk about that. When we don't even really have a script. Like, so we if we get picked up, are you like prepared to like not go to Florida and everything?
You were asked that.
Yeah, and I was like, dude, fuck you, man.
Wait,
what?
Who asked?
They remain nameless.
That's a weird. Well, here's the thing, like, it's fun to daydream, you know, but like at the end of it, like,
they're like,
people choosing
YouTube
over.
Would you like not go to Florida? I'm like,
well, Joey, I think it's hard. Joey, Joey, I think you, I think you picked the right choice for staying here and not going to over choosing the show. I appreciate it. Sorry, I'm giving you a hard time.
You make me cry in front of all these microphones.
We have 8 boom mic guys.
We got a press. This is actually a press conference.
We have a SWAT team outside.
Richie, my brother showed me your endeavor at the film. Before it had started, you had gone up to the front of the theater.
Dude, that was amazing.
What are you talking about?
That was so funny.
I Happy too. Death Day when you went up on stage.
Oh, yeah.
Was that?
Okay, because
was that any good?
Oh, dude.
I heard it wasn't bad.
It's fucking fun, dude. Yeah, it's fun as hell, and it's awesome.
Can we go
Tuesday? I would love to go Tuesday. Okay. I would love to see it again. It's tons of fun. It doesn't pretend like it's like...
Not what it is.
Exactly. It doesn't pretend like it's a super serious, like... I hated the advertisement for it because
it was advertised.
It made it so obnoxious.
Happy Death Day.
And it's like, oh, fuck you.
Like, fuck off.
That's how they get you.
It's almost like if somebody... advertised a Darren Beef Stroganoff Albrekoski's movie as a horror movie.
Right.
It's not a horror movie at all. Oh, wait, that's happened like twice.
Right. Yes! Dude, oh my god. But it was
Beef
so fun.
Stroganoff.
It's
Beef.
So funny. If you guys, I don't know if it's going to be too late, I don't know when this is going up, but go see Happy Death Day. It's fucking fun as hell.
Now, it'll still be relevant. This will probably be up in a week. So whenever you're watching this, probably on, it depends where you listen
Never.
To. If you're listening to this on
If
iTunes,
you're listening in Russia.
If you're listening in
if
Russia.
If you're listening in Prussia. If you're listening in the Soviet fucking Union.
If you're listening in the Soviet Union. Oh god, Snapchat.
Absolutely.
I had a blast with that. I love that script. I hope you don't change my part too much.
Absolutely.
For some background, part of Joey's film, and I was probably irritating the shit out of everybody, but,
I was having fun.
No, I had a blast.
You were one of the few people that wasn't irritating.
I was still
absolute,
playing the character.
The fuck out of me. It was...
No, I just, there's a lot of confetti with that
story. Yeah, no, this is my thing. Aw, oh, man, they're reading a script, and there's a big camera in front of them? Let's fucking talk at full volume. I hope you know who you are.
Oh, wait a minute. Do I sense that? I don't...
I can't remember
who you know who you are.
Can't see, I just... Was it Cam? I don't even
I don't
remember.
Know why I'm staring into the microphone like I'm deadpanning at the camera.
Yeah, like the man's face is like the microphone.
Yeah, like,
you
know, is there, really is there a fisheye lens on this?
I do gotta say, while we're on topic, I didn't think I'd like doing a podcast this much. I'm having a blast. I think this is fun.
I'm having a great
because
time.
It's great. Like I said, like some people you turn on a camera, you turn on you start recording. They shut
completely
down.
They turn into down. Statue people.
Look, it's like well, sorry. So did you guys ever understand that? Like why people really do that?
I mean,
not really. Because... I mean. I'll tell you why. It's because of these damn phones. I'll tell
it's
ya.
It's these damn phones. And
people,
it's the fucking hippies.
It's the fucking hippies.
People vlog on Snapchat all the
time.
Like,
no,
nothing,
but
you know?
I'll tell you something.
Yeah, but when they do that, they turn into somebody else.
That's
yes, exactly. This is like some conspiracy theory shit. Nobody is themselves on anything, and they like construct their social media and like their Snapchat
sure.
to make everybody else perceive them in a way.
Thank you, Jim right. Terry.
Yes.
Oh,
exactly.
Yeah.
You're right.
Honestly, like, okay, like I said, there's some shit he's saying and I'm like, what the fuck, man? But a lot of the shit he's saying, I'm like, no, I get it. Like, I even feel that way in everyday life.
Oh, just
life.
That everyone's kind of a little disappointed.
Like, you know how I felt a lot
yeah.
through high school.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
everyone's like, oh, you're the funny guy!
Well, that's both comedians and high school in general. Now, comedians, everyone, I think
okay.
it's getting
yeah,
more
luckily,
shined on.
I was fucking
yeah.
both, you know?
Speaking of all this, like, speaking of having, like, a perceived vision from everybody
mm-hmm.
by you and that being enhanced
mm-hmm.
by social media,
yeah.
fucking American Vandal. Holy
I
shit.
I haven't seen it yet.
Yes.
I've
that show
yet.
Is one of the most brilliant things ever.
I just
oh,
have this to-do
list. It's so good because you laugh.
Yeah.
And then out of nowhere, you're emotionally invested.
You're
in
emotionally
show.
Invested.
Isn't
like,
that
so
way? That's the
it's come to the
equation.
Point where it doesn't even feel like it's scripted. And it's actually
really?
Dateline.
Yes! Dude, it's like...
it's
so good.
That's
I'm screaming.
What I'm saying, like, that is the new... That is the new equation. You get people hooked on comedy, take it, and I love it that way.
It's
nuts.
Yeah. Honestly, I'm surprised
like Rick and
nobody's...
Morty and
Rick and
like all that
the,
shit.
The real
and...
big one, because if anyone's seen the pilot of Rick and Morty, I thought it was awful. I thought the pilot was just a travesty. I did not think
well,
it was
it's
very
changed
good. Oh, that's what I'm saying. Yeah,
well,
I enjoyed
point.
The show.
Yeah.
I think
yeah,
the show's
yeah.
fantastic. Everything about the show is fantastic, except for the fans. and a little woman we'll call Tumblr. But I mean, you have Rick and Morty, Futurama. I want to credit Futurama, kind of.
I'm sorry, I'll say it. I personally like Futurama better.
Oh yeah.
That's just
Futurama had
and I'll say this.
But hey, the people that get pissed at that are also the same people that get pissed when I say 21 Pilots suck. But hey,
I like 21. I don't like that blurry face is bad, but I like them. I think they're fantastic.
Yeah, I will say this right now. If you know this about me, everybody,
gay.
Well, you know. Come on now. I hate Futurama.
Do you?
I've never laughed at anything less in my life.
Oh no! It's because most of the time you're actually just crying.
Yeah.
No, it's I hate it.
Really? Have you seen the films?
I have not.
That's what I started with.
I watched.
Yeah. I thought the films were the films. I would argue are better.
My
than
My favorite.
Show.
I couldn't tell you the name. It's the one where with Lars and
is that,
Fry and the
is
I'm
that
not gonna say
Bender's Game.
No, yeah, no. Wait, no, it might. No, it's the one where Bender had 01001.
Oh, isn't that
Yami? Oh, wait, no, that's the same one. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's the one with the giant tentacle monster.
Yeah, because Fry has a tattoo on his ass.
Hey, Richie, I'm on your team. I hate Futurama.
Really?
Never,
oh, my God. I've never talked to somebody that hates Futurama.
No,
okay, listen.
We're not like.
I don't hate Futurama.
We're not going to freak
out.
No,
I understand.
Rick and Morty fans.
Yeah, right? You hate Rick and Morty? What are
you
fucking understand?
Stand
it. You must not get it. Let me explain it to you.
Really
fucking
explain
cunt.
It, because most
depressed.
Of the shit's not accurate at all in this world. So what do you mean explain it?
Right, yeah.
See, here's the thing. I think the Rick and Morty fan... I'm going to get shit for this. I think a lot of the Rick and Morty fan base is like depressed and not smart. So they're watching it and trying to
like
being depressed
oh, dude,
and smart.
Fuck school.
Right.
This
is
killed himself in his garage. That's how life's supposed to be.
And like, they think, like, the people that make Rick and Morty are, like, fucking geniuses. Like, they fucking know everything about, like...
And
it's fucking... It's a dumbass Justin Royal and just getting drunk.
I think... Wait, hold on. I would add in... I think all of us love Rick and Morty, too.
Oh, my God. I love Rick and Morty so much.
We're just appalled by
Rick and
Morty. Tumblr, you know?
Right.
We'll just say Tumblr.
Yeah.
This is the anti-Tumblr.
Welcome to the anti-Tumblr.
That's how we should have introduced it.
You
welcome to the sugar-free podcast. We hate Tumblr.
I feel like it's even such a small part. I don't use Tumblr, but I still feel like even the small... Because it's the people who use Tumblr like that who we see reblogging on other things. So I feel like it might not even be that much.
Unlike a real website.
Yeah. Let's publish just for like 13-year-old depressed women in Notch. So
I don't like Tumblr.
Oh yeah.
And Joey, the movie you talked about is Bender's Big Score.
Ah, that's what was the musical?
The musical
was that Bender's Big Score?
There wasn't a musical.
It was the one with Santa?
And Santa trying to kill
him? Oh, that wasn't a full movie.
Yeah, that was just an episode.
That was just an episode.
They have a few episodes with him,
Yeah. I remember...
That was like the yearly Christmas special.
My brother loves Futurama, and I was watching it with him. And
did
like,
he
was.
No,
I was just hanging out with him because I love my family.
I should get a tattoo of Bender on my ass.
That's definitely not a good idea.
Is that like a reference or?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey,
cool. Okay, let me add this in. I do think you guys would both genuinely enjoy the show. I'm not gonna force it on you. But if you know one of these days and now
if you
we
were
all
shown
have
the right thing, I mean, then again, I don't hate it. It's just like every time I've ever watched it, they were probably bad episodes, and I didn't laugh. And then my cousins like really loved it, so they kind of forced it on me. So I was like, I don't like.
Well,
that
it's got Futurama has a really linear progression. It's not a very quotable show. Am I right there? Like,
I mean. Like, there's a couple.
I feel like the only quotable mentions are mostly from Bender.
Yeah.
Right, because, like, I don't...
I did like Bender as a character,
like,
too.
There's Bender and Slurms McKenzie.
I forgot about Slurms was dope.
I get that, what you're saying, too, because, like, Rick and Morty has, like, Wubba Lubba Dub Dub and, like, shit like that.
It's funny as fuck.
I mean, great paid. You simpletons don't understand.
Oh, jeez, Louise, Morty.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Music alleys. They need to stop.
Yeah, but, like, Futurama definitely didn't have... I didn't see any of that. Like, I was watching it, like, fully expecting to laugh. Like, I've heard about Futurama being funny, and, like, my brother was hyping it up, and I was like, hell yeah, let's watch Futurama. And we were, like, two seasons in, and I laughed, like, twice.
Really?
Yeah, I don't like
it.
Two seasons
in, I would say it gets better.
I'm a little different here.
I mean, I don't know.
Futurama never... I like the comedy.
I
never
don't
hooked me in with the comedy. I
thought the story.
Yeah, I was hooked in from the story.
Absolutely.
The comedy never.
Really?
Ever.
Yeah.
When you say Futurama, the first thing that comes to mind is absolutely not the laughs.
Yeah.
I just think
so,
the characters
like,
are fun.
I think it's very fun and I think it's funny.
I don't
but when
get
I think
it.
Of Futurama,
I really
about crying over Fry's dog.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you look at Futurama.
I think it's a wonderfully written show.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they're like writers from like Harvard, aren't they? Is that right?
I don't know.
The majority of them?
Matt Groening or whatever.
Well,
like the writer from The Simpsons.
Yeah, that's Matt Groening. But Groening, whatever. Which is, you know, that's a good point to bring up. Like, that's probably the biggest thing it would get compared to at the time is The Simpsons, right?
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
And the thing with The Simpsons is, like, that is absolutely for the laughter.
Right.
Like,
I've never watched The Simpsons either.
I grew up on
I
The
haven't
Simpsons.
Either.
Mm-mm.
I grew up on it, and there is some funny fucking... While Conan was... Conan O'Brien, while he
I
wrote
love
for the
Conan
show,
O'Brien.
While he wrote for that, that was the funniest shit.
He is still the best talk show host.
Still the best talk show host, number
Do
one.
We all
you
agree
know
on
why? You know why?
Brian.
Because I like Fallon.
I was going to say, you
and
love
I,
Fallon.
I definitely used to love him when
yeah.
I was younger, but you know why Conan, like... I mean, he clearly cares about his job, but he doesn't give a shit. Like, he doesn't care about being, like, politically correct.
Yeah, yeah.
He's just, like, talking to people.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, no, I disagree with that.
Really?
How so?
I think Conan is so good and so fantastic and so amazing because every other talk show host is trying to just be like, yeah, I'm just me. This is just how I am. I'm just talking to these celebs. And
well,
like,
no, that's what they're trying to do.
That's what they're
to
trying
it.
To
I
do.
I think he just does it effortlessly.
Yeah.
Well, I think Conan O'Brien...
I think he has, like, really good questions. I think he does...
Yeah.
He has wonderful conversations
he
with
does.
His people. And he just literally makes anything fucking funny.
Well,
and
Conan
he's not
O'Brien,
fake. He's himself.
He's himself, and like, but still, like, every single thing that he's doing, he doesn't, like, everyone, like, relies on, like, the fake stories that these celebrities are talking about to be funny.
Yeah.
But, like, Conan O'Brien, like,
it's
his
just a
character,
fun guy to watch.
His character, he's playing a character most of the time, and it's fucking
Dude,
hilarious.
I'm going to weigh out on the other end here, you guys are both right. But like Bill Burr, for example, you guys know Bill Burr.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was on the show.
Yes.
Very rough time for him. I think he was talking about must have been his father, his relationship with his father, which was not good. Obviously, he's struggling to get through it, and Conan's just like the guy had class. He just like patted him on the back, pushed everything along in the most appropriate way while still like showing sympathy. Because obviously, like the questions were pretty much submitted by the guests, you know. So I just thought it was incredible because I know watching that on like Fallon or who is it, Colbert, like they would, it would just be awkward.
That's my thing. It would just Fallon, be like that's one thing. Like I think he's, see, like I'm happy that
he's like
the Tonight Show.
Good guy.
I don't think he's the best talk show host.
I don't
because
think
this is my thing. He was great on SNL. And he's great in sketch comedy. He's fucking
that,
funny.
Yeah.
But this is my thing. As far as like being an interviewer and doing, like you said, he relies on stories too much.
Mm-hmm.
And no matter what, you'll hear this from. Oh my god, it's so funny. This guy's hilarious. Oh my god, you are the best. This guy is the absolute funniest. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Let me tell you. Ah, we love you. We love you.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what he does.
And like they'll say some like the celebrity will say some like self-demeaning thing and he'll be like, No, we love you here. And yeah,
exactly. No, we don't curse.
Right.
We love you.
Right.
We absolutely love you.
I think he I see where you're coming from.
He's cute.
He does better with the shorter things where he does play a character.
Exactly.
Like undoubtedly, like
his sketches
cool.
are
they're fantastic. They're
really
fantastic.
Good.
They're always to the point too.
Absolutely. And
yeah.
I don't like him per se, but I think James Corden is good as well.
I love Reggie Watts, so you could put him with anyone.
I think he's good at what he does. I don't really
Hey guys, have you seen Reggie Watts lately?
Yeah, he lost a ton
he
of weight.
Lost a lot of weight.
Yeah, remember like 8 months ago when he was the fat ass music maker?
How is the fat ass music maker?
Now
yeah.
he's fucking
the skinny ass music
there.
Maker.
He's fu- no, he's not skinny,
there's
dude.
Not skinny.
He's buff.
Yeah.
He's fucking like
just like that.
Yeah.
Just like that.
His hair is left poofy though.
And I'm gonna transition this back to the show too. When it because like even when we started writing more of a we need to wrap this up. Is that the?
No, I was farted.
All right. Oh,
I
learned
to ignore it. I heard it though.
Oh God! I should have drawn light to that. Back to the show is we found ourselves like writing these sketches and stuff that we could just turn into scenes. And that's more or less what we did. So, like, because I'll say it, dude. Maybe it's just me. Writing sketches is way fucking harder than writing a show.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Writing sketches is fucking hard.
Because you have a deadline. Because you have, like, a beginning.
Yeah.
And, like, you have to make that beginning turn into something funny
yeah.
by the end.
Yeah.
And it's also because with what we're doing as far as the story with these characters, we've become familiar. So we continue this thing. It's an elongated
yeah.
thing.
Right.
But with sketches, you have to come up with these characters, the
yeah.
plot, and it has to be in this.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
a very confined thing. Whereas
overworld.
What we're doing with the overworld,
yeah.
it's
yeah.
much more familiar,
mm-hmm.
and we've done a lot, and we're very familiar. So
I don't think
easy.
We've actually talked about the concept of show really.
Oh, we probably
so like.
About,
yeah.
oh. I was gonna say with it's almost like. With writing, like, the story of writers, it's
yeah.
almost like working at a job we've worked at for a while. But with sketches, it's like starting a new job.
Yeah.
It's
right.
like, oh, we're, okay.
Yeah.
Shit.
Shit.
Right
okay,
into
what's
it.
Going
this is, it's not them, it's new people.
My God,
right.
Joe, you're clipping the mic
oh,
so
wow.
much.
Oh, wow.
That's fine, I can fix it.
Listen, it's okay.
And so it's gonna be okay.
It's gonna be okay. Yeah.
So like
yeah,
the concept
right.
of the show, we're a group of workers.
Shut the fuck up for you.
And
I need water. I'll be right back.
Okay. We're a group of waters. Wow! Holy shit! I can't believe that just fucking happened. We're a group of waters.
Made on a buttery,
crispy flake.
he hesitated the word waters twice. He's like, we're a bunch of
waters.
What?
Made on a buttery,
flavored
buddy.
Oh
buttery
my God,
crispy
I love
bust.
He just slowly forgets how to say the word buttery. Made on a buddy.
Can I have some of your Dr. Pepper?
Ooh,
flavored.
Yes. Give
no.
me them.
Yes, you can.
Oh, no. Give me it.
Give me it. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
God damn it. We're cutting this out.
Yeah,
no,
I'll cut
this
podcast.
This is podcast
know.
Poison.
It really is.
Literally. But it's sugar free.
Yeah.
But
continue.
It is sugar free.
Continue.
You stupid
piece of shit.
I'll fix that.
Fix that!
It's got chickmunk
feet. It's got chickmunk feet on it.
Chickmunk. What are you talking about?
If it's hairy, then just get me like.
It's fine. Talk about
the
show.
Okay, so the show is we're at office and we write for a shitty sketch comedy show. It's like it's very vague to keep like it open and like fresh and like
we work on a poor man's Rockefeller Center building.
Pretty much, exactly. And like There is a quote-unquote Peter Griffin in the office, which is my character, and I'm just a crazy, fat, fucking partying motherfucker that doesn't take anything seriously, and I'm pretty much what gets the office into, like, the shenanigans, pretty much. And all the characters, like, react to that and stuff. But we're going for that, but we're also... We might do some sketches, too, as well. Like, show, like, the sketches that the group would have, like, written for the show. But that's not really a main focus of the show at this point, I don't think.
I don't know. Which, doing sketches that, like, the characters of the show be making is actually easier. Because the intention is for them to be shitty now.
Yeah.
Well, I guess.
Weird. It's weird. We kind of dug ourselves in a hole with that one, right. To be honest.
Right, yeah.
Like I said, sketches are hard. But I think the hardest part about sketches is actually the props and the environment. That's so dependent. Because, mm-hmm. like, with improv, like, there are no props.
Is this
props,
diet?
So, yeah.
Yeah, thanks for telling me.
Are you fucking kidding me? You don't have to drink it, mate.
It's too late.
Too late to what?
Apologize.
You can't spit that back out.
Mate.
Mate.
Am I the
only one who says mate? Am I?
No, I say mate all the time.
Okay. I mean, I say it's
when I'm doing it.
Well, James, I think it's a little too late for you to ask that, considering you've been saying it all your life.
Have I?
Yeah.
Really? Okay.
Really?
Did you just look at your watch to say all of your life?
Well, first off,
it was a joke, Kyle. Don't,
dude. It was a bitch.
It was a fucking bitch!
It was a bitch.
Can we say bitch now?
It was a bitch.
It was a bitch.
Oh my god. What the fuck is up, Kyle?
Should we go around discussing how our characters are?
Yeah, sure, that's fine.
Okay, so, Richie, you explain yours. Rick, if you want to explain yours. Yeah. Rick's Rick. No, I'm kidding. Go.
Alright, so I'm Rick. It started off as a satirized version of myself, and now I'm just, like, insane?
I would say...
There's a question mark behind that, because we don't know.
He's a creep. He's like creep.
I was going to say creep.
Yeah.
And when we're comparing
he's creep, but, like, turned up to a
yeah.
left.
Yeah.
It's like creep if they showed him more.
Like, creep if, like... He was also Mac. And Charlie at the
same time. So here's the thing. Creep was never an enabler. Rick is totally an enabler for Plot.
He's a lot like Creed in the sense that he fought Rocky Balboa and they became friends.
All right, guys, we're going to cut to a clip.
Let's cut to the clip Mac of 2015.
I would say, can we compare characters to other characters?
Yeah, sure.
God bless you.
Hey, thanks.
We haven't put out the product yet. So this is just kind of referencing. It doesn't mean they're rip-offs, but this is just to get a sense. But yeah, it's Creed.
Like I said, the thing that makes it not rip-offs is, like we said, it started off as a satirized version of most of us. And then there's people like me who can't act to save their fucking life, so we just play a straight man.
Yeah.
But, like, it's... I mean...
So that's James' explanation for his character.
Yeah, I keep the gears going, I guess. I also like writing dialogue, too. Can I take some credit for dialogue? Is that cool? I don't know. I like writing dialogue.
Well, no, we're talking about your character.
Oh, right on.
Yeah, just your character. Yeah, so, yeah.
Yeah, so I keep the gears going.
I'd like to... James's character is, like, to me... He's, like, a straight man,
but,
like, he's been through the ringer, like, so much. So, like, his reactions to shit is, like, kind of dulled down.
Yeah.
And, like, he expects all this shit to happen. So he's not, like, really, like, whoa, what the fuck's going on? He's like, oh, Jesus, here we go again.
Whoa. Yeah, right. I think,
Yeah, Zach's character is more of like the reactionary kind of guy.
Yeah, because Zach is kind of the virgin ears
of
the
office. So he's like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, I worked at an Arby's before.
Right, exactly.
I was just a simpleton working at Arby's.
Right, and then Logan is... Logan's my favorite, I think.
Have you guys ever seen that 70s show? You know the character Kelso? Well, let's pretend Kelso genuinely had a mental disorder. That's Logan.
Well, he's going to listen to this. He's going to be like, what are they doing with me?
I love Logan so much. I love Logan's character so much. He's so easy to write.
Right. He's so easy to remember, but he contributes. Because he's just nothing. So
fucking stupid. You know how in the show Michael Kelso gets with a dumb blonde? Logan's their kid.
Yes! Yes! Oh my god, that's great. Oh, I fucking... He's just the fucking dumbest sack of shit.
Let's go through everyone here. Right. We'll talk about the rest of the cast, and then we'll end the podcast.
Kyle?
It's good for you, like...
Okay.
My character is more of like I try to get everybody to get on focus. Like I'm, I don't know.
I know what you mean.
How would you describe my character?
I think that's right. Like,
well, I try to keep everybody on track, but every now and then I do some shenanigan-esque things with everybody.
He's a lenient overseer.
Sure. Yeah. Well, I think Kyle's thing is Kyle wants everything he needs to get done to get done. But past that, he couldn't be bothered. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I kind of see that. True. Like, his character is kind of like...
Doesn't matter how it gets done.
He's the cool teacher.
He's the cool teacher?
That's pretty good.
I don't know. Like, I mean, I don't not see it, but I don't...
I do, as far as what I read. Because he's like, all right, guys.
Because once I get done with, like...
But just get what I want done and keep on task after that.
Yeah.
Be you.
Oh, sure. Yeah, for sure.
Yes, okay.
His character is brought into the show in the first episode, and he is a lawyer.
He's a lawyer, yeah.
And, like, he is supposed to, like, keep all the group out of, like, trouble and shit. And, like, yeah, I guess, yeah. So, like, keep people out of trouble, and, like, past that, like, what the fuck ever, man. I'm good. You know?
He's the teacher that was cool with all the bad
Yeah, and I guess I'm like,
he plays acoustic guitar and says his students are hot.
And listen. He plays acoustic guitar.
I'm not going to say my students are hot.
To Jimmy
Hendrix. I'm not going to say the student is... I love his face when he does that.
What is this reference to?
American Vandal.
Sorry. Again. Joey, your character?
Funniest fucking thing. Joey, I'm unemployed.
All right, great. So that's
no. I don't know. For the longest time, I was really pissed and frustrated and like interconflicted about my character.
Sure.
At first, I liked it. Then I was like, no.
Well, you want to explain why?
I would say, well, it wasn't what I wanted, and I just get what I want. No. it was just more the sense that I was. I don't know. I was wanted to be, as far as, like I said, we're just comparing characters so you can get a sense. As far as archetype, I wanted to be, like, a weird combination between Michael and Jim. And I guess...
I kind of got a little bit of Andy, that's why I always kind
of... That's, yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. Just kind of a combination of a character and a straight man.
Sure, yeah.
And then I kind of got to the point where I was just a straight man. I wasn't even a straight man. I was just there. And I didn't like it. But I was... And I... There's this really cool dynamic that I came up with a while ago that me and Richie kind of fleshed out. That me and him have been buddies for the longest time. Like, even going past this job. And then me and him... Because me and him... We have a really weird chemistry.
Yeah.
It's so strong. It's like, but it's the weirdest thing.
That's what I was gonna say. It's not really descriptive.
This is the only way I can explain it. It's like a slightly homoerotic version of E.T. and Elliot.
What? Holy shit, that's the best. Why have you never told me that before? That's the best fucking thing I've ever heard.
Because one of
us,
it's very plausible that one of us would go up and touch each other's penis.
Don't you even do the
with our index finger and go, ouch.
Don't you even do the face that Elliot does where, like, where he sees E.T. in the dress and he goes, ah!
Yeah. So that's what we are. We're like if E.T. and Elliot like dated for a while.
I think you guys always had this funny back and forth thing where Richie will like sexually harass you and like really push and he'll just keep pushing you until you finally reciprocate it and then Richie will be like Mark Wahlberg in The Happening, he'll be like, what? No.
it's like Roger and Steve.
Oh yeah, sure.
I was wanting that, and, like, my character's weirdness to show through me and him, and that wasn't being done, and it was coming to the point where I really didn't have time to write.
I mean, I'm just trying to throw out the moral, like, if you guys have any ideas for a bigger scale project, but you're like, oh, I don't have this yet, Just start working on it. Seriously. Just start, get people, I don't care, how, like, we have, one of the people who helps write for us, Gage, he's still in high school, and he's doing all this stuff. I think that's amazing. So, it doesn't matter how old you are.
Do what you can. Yeah. Honestly, like,
yeah, just push
do your best.
Yeah.
Do what you can. Like, if you're stressed, and like I said, like, when I was younger, I was like, oh, dude, this would be so cool, but I literally have no way. I have no money. I'm still little. Like, my thing is, honestly, like, if you're in that point, do what you can. Yeah. If you can't do this, and if you can't record, and you can't do this, fucking write it.
Yeah.
Do whatever can be done. Do whatever can be done. To move the steps forward, because once you get everything else, that's already done.
Yeah, and Richie can tell you this better than anyone, or I guess me too. Because
film it on a fucking phone. Yeah, film it make on it phone. The best film fucking phone anything, movie ever.
Anything you're working, and we have people doing everything. It doesn't matter if it's art. It doesn't matter if it's music. Doesn't matter if it's a show. Write it the first time you do it. It's going to suck. It's going to be awful.
Shit.
Just keep doing it. Filter it out. Take the best parts. And then bring it to the table. Once it's actually perfect, you know, like, we had a great support system of checks and balances throughout all this. But if you brought something to the table and you're like, no, guys, trust me, it's going to get better. It's not. If you couldn't even put it in its full and then introduce it.
We're not Quentin and fucking Eli Roth talking to you here. We're just regular people, like, doing it. Like, we're doing it. Like, we got our resources, and we haven't even made it yet, but still, we're getting it done.
And if it's a game
so
of...
So if we can do it...
Yeah.
Because I'll tell you what, I have zero work ethic with a lot of things.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Oh, so if I'm like, okay, so here's a test that's going to determine your life after school. Oh, fuck you. You want to make a movie for zero profit? Absolutely.
Nice to meet you.
I will give you all of my attention.
Take my
forever.
Kidney. No, let me throw this out there. And if you're asking the question, why should we listen to these guys? They're just on James's fucking Spotify channel talking about something. We have no way to tell that they're successful. Well, honestly, at the end of the day, worst case scenario, we're 14 guys in Hannah meeting every week and having a fucking blast.
Yeah, we have
making
a good time.
And also, you shouldn't be asking yourself,
that's what
why should you listen? Like, because if you're asking yourself that question right now, why the fuck have you even been listening this long?
Joey, so hold him back. Hold him back. No, stop. No. Max, no. No. But, like, seriously, like, what... When people will be like, dude, I want to be in a band. I want to be in a rock band. It sounds great. It's like, why do you want to be in a rock band? I've heard people say, like, because of just having that tight-knit group of people. Well, that's...
That's an amazing reason.
It's a good reason, and that's what we have. So what more are we asking?
Guess what? We're making content, because guess what? I can't play no guitar.
But I can sure open a Google Docs.
That's going on the shirt.
I can't play guitar, but I can sure open Google Docs.
So we run through some other characters. Cam... He's our Toby, yeah?
Yes.
Cam's our Toby. Yeah. Cade, he's our... What's Cade?
I don't even know. Well,
I don't know what he is, but I know
well,
me
Cade,
and him...
Cade, I'll tell you what Cade is. Cade is like...
Jimmy.
Jimmy.
That's Jimmy. Well, no, because I wanted Jimmy in this fucking show, so Cade is Jimmy now. Don't push back on this again. I have some little plastic thing I've been chewing on.
Oh, dude, you're so weird.
Oh my god, you're so weird.
Anyways, what is Cade?
Cade is like the motherfucker that'll kick down the door. And
oh,
like,
yeah.
He's like crazy. And
well,
like,
I mean, he has pushed a ton of stuff along for us in terms of just finding that missing element
right.
And what we need
he's,
to really push
he's
things
loud,
along.
He's loud,
yeah,
he's volatile, he's
very
like
volatile.
Fucking... He's just like, and he's like fucking scary, and he like...
You know
like,
not to test him, because he'll do what he's...
And that's an element
I don't know
really
why me
needed, that
yeah.
we didn't know we needed, like, we
yeah.
didn't know what it was.
Until
yeah.
we saw Cade...
Until we saw Cade grabs Richie's sword
and hit it on a tree.
Just hack it on a
yeah,
tree.
Yeah, Cade, if you're listening to this, a fucking
okay, so...
Then again, me and Cade still have... We have, like, a relationship kind of thing.
Oh, yeah.
We were back
yeah.
in high school.
Back
still doing that.
Yeah, I want that to be canon. Is that can that be canon? Fuck you, it's canon.
No, it'll be an Elseworld story.
But your guys'
relationship will be the Killing Joke of writers.
Oh god.
Just terrible and messy.
Fuck Killing Joke.
I don't know how we can work that in because like I'm like a No, we trying can, to move we things can, forward. No, yeah, he's no, allowed.
We can, we can, we can talk
we
about
can,
this.
We can get Mark Hamill.
We can talk about this after the podcast.
Okay, okay. Oh, yeah, you're probably
we're gonna
right.
Take so guys, thanks for yeah. Listening. How fuck?
This has been about an hour.
Jesus, no, like two.
This is, yeah,
not and I'll be real with you. This has made me feel really.
We started.
Important.
We started the this take yeah, at 9:30.
Only Richard.
Really?
Yeah, we started this.
Okay, well, not as bad as I thought.
Yeah.
We should definitely wrap it up,
we'll wrap
though,
it.
For sure.
I had fun.
This is...
I can't wait to start
this
doing this.
Should we do this again?
Yeah. I thought we were going to do
absolutely.
This, like...
I'm fucking
oh,
sucking
sure.
Your cock.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
God damn.
So, I mean, if you're listening still, hell yeah. Thank
yeah,
you so much.
Thank
like,
so
god
much.
Damn, we didn't ask you to do that.
Yeah, but, yeah, for the sugar-free podcast...
I'm Rich.
I'm Rick.
James.
Kyle.
And I'm Joey, and we'll see you guys later.
Suck your dad.